Engineer Babagana Mohammed, Fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, a past chairman of the Victoria Island branch of the society, was in a glorious assembly which gathered at the International Conference Center in Abuja and was sworn in as the 32nd president of the Nigerian Society of Engineers.
A nation that is serious about building self-reliance and equivalent property of its citizens will not neglect technical and vocational interests at the basic level. That is probably the reason why Nigerian youth roam the street daily in search of jobs that are not available. After graduating from Nigerian universities,
basically, technical and vocational education training, as said by the president, and all of us here, I'm sure I would agree with him, is a key ingredient to our development in terms of competitiveness and in terms of having the skill and requisite competencies for us as a society to compete globally with any other competitor, whether within the country or outside the country.
We are trying to revamp our own technical and vocational education, indeed, even our education.
Born intelligent engineer in his acceptance speech laid emphasis on building the country on different fronts.
The federal government of Prime has promised to give 100 million Nigerians out of poverty. That is a progression in our nation. The issue here is very simple. Buhari does not say, I am going to carry 100 million Nigerians to farming to get out of poverty. No. What Buhari is looking at? Buhari is looking at engineers to fix what is fixed out and get 100 million Nigerians out of poverty. Nigerian engineers, you have a task, and I am going to be their focal point. Is the agreement of study group to carry out holistic assessment, a program of social development? Yes. We are concerned. Power. We are concerned. Water. We are concerned because energy is about public safety and security. Power is still an issue. Why? Why? I'm going to be asking why every day. For how long do you want to be asking why? For how long? Today we are 60 years as a professional body. We have to stop asking why. We have to say yes. And I know we can.
He further stressed on the importance of young engineering graduates getting necessary help to be able to create jobs by equipping them with skills relevant in the 21st century.
A Nigerian engineering graduate looking for work. A Nigerian engineering graduate looking for work. Something is technically wrong. If you cannot create jobs for others, you have to create jobs for yourself. That is key. We are going to work. We are going to take up the community. We are going to work with Korea. Yes, education has to be skill-based, outcome-based. We will tie to what is competitive, to what is happening globally. It is no longer about, I am a graduate. No. No. You are a graduate, yes, you can read the book, fine. But what can you do? Such is your.
In attendance in the history-making event are the Executive Governor of Borno, Engineer Professor Babagana Zulu, the Executive Governor of Yobe State, Honorable Mai Buni, immediate past Governor of Borno State, who is currently a member of the National Assembly, Senator Kashim Shettima, President of the Council for the Regulation of Engineering Nigeria, past President of the Society, Fellows, and important personalities both from within and outside the engineering ecosystem were all in attendance. The dignitaries took turns to give reassurance on the competence of Engineer Babagana Mohammed, FNSE, in their remarks, expressing their confidence in him and encouraging him to do as he said he'll do in his acceptance speech.
Mr. Gentlemen, the immediate past president and the current president, and I'm able to deduce two very important things. Nigeria is dependent on fossil fuel as main source of its revenue is a matter of great concern. And secondly, the mismatch between our engineering education and the labor market struck industry is also a matter of great concern. We shall continue to support the Nigerian Society of Engineers with a view to meeting its objectives of sustainable development.
The outgoing president, Engineer Olumuyiwa Mokolu, FNSE, and Engineer Aishatu Omari, Chairman of the Presidential Investiture Committee, also took their time, respectively, to encourage the new president in upholding the ideals of the society and ensuring that he gives his best to taking the society to a greater height.
The team for this program today, Engineering Infrastructure for Unity and Progress in Nigeria. The team of this occasion is very unique and important, as well as germane to sustainable growth of our dear country, Nigeria, and to the great of our esteemed society of the Nigerian Society of Engineers.
My dear President, Engineer Babagana Mohammed, Fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, is now saddled with the responsibility of ensuring that all Nigerians focus on Nigerian engineers to achieve the new goals stated in the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs. This, I believe, my 32nd president is well equipped and positioned to do, and I pray we shall witness 2030 to celebrate and enjoy these achievements together.
Attendees also have a lot to say about Engineer Babagana Mohammed, FNSE, encouraging and advising him on how best to lead the society.
I am his chief advisor, and I will always make sure that the plan he has reeled out today for the society, I will make sure that I advise him on the implementation, the best way to implement, and any other issue that comes up, because issues come up that are not in our plan. We'll make sure that we advise the president in accordance with the mandate and the aspirations of the Nigerian engineers.
Everything that he has promised in his speech, we should pay attention to it and ensure that he carries them out. He should not allow himself to be derailed. He should go back to that speech over and over again and read it over and over again so that he can do what he has said he will do.
I'm very sure that there is no perfection in any human being. Wherever he is lacking, we are ready in making sure that we cooperate with them. So you should see everybody, male or female, young and old, as his project.
Engineer Babagana is not new in the engineering family. Even in the cadre, from branch chairman into the national executive, So you see, all his efforts in the past, and part of it is what you are seeing.
He's a man that takes firm decisions. He might look simple, but he's very, very competent and very, very decisive. He's a man that asks questions when there is need. He's a man that seeks for advice when there is need. And I'm very, very sure that we'll go for all this. These are the qualities. He's one of the very best the engineering profession has on offer. Let's watch out this space in the next 2 years.
After all said and done, it is clear, like the handwriting on the wall, that Engineer Babagana Mohammed is exactly what the entire engineering community needs at this time when Nigeria needs to double its effort in building the nation.